Well, if you found yourself reaching for the purple today and then thought, I don't need that purple this Friday after all, you were certainly not alone. For the first time since 2007, Ravens fans find themselves without the purple on a postseason Friday. And perhaps that's why some people turn to the black and gold, though that does get complicated. Here's 11 News' Deborah Wiener.
In some places, it was like you saw every color but purple. On this first, well, purple-less Friday in 5 years.
You miss it being a purple Friday today?
Oh, yes. Don't we all?
That's depressing. It really is.
Would you have had purple on today?
Yes, absolutely.
Purple stopped us in our tracks when we saw these young sledders, but we were wrong.
Why are you wearing your purple today?
Because it's actually the only bigger jacket I have.
A faded Ravens flag caught our eye, and soon we found hope springing eternal from a fan named Robert Spring.
Every Friday, purple.
Okay, so no matter what?
Baseball season, purple. Friday.
For some, though, the void has been filled with that black and yellow combination as they cheer on the Towson Tigers.
Leave no doubt. That's
even our morning anchor team got in the act, sporting the colors of this day.
Go Towson.
I'm just glad that we have a team that's actually in the playoffs still, and you know, that we can still root for.
But we all know that wearing Towson colors can have its ups and downs. Just ask these elevator mechanics.
Yeah, you can't wear yellow and black. As much as I like to see Towson win the national championship, I can't wear yellow and black. That's the Steelers' color. It's just not heard of here.
Perhaps it's why the governor, who was reminded he wagered crab cakes for North Dakota pasta, chose a neutral palette.
Towson football team, I hope they win.
On this Friday that really looks more white than just about anything, we thought we'd let the smallest sledder have the final say.
But, and you have a purple cast on your arm. Is that for the Ravens?
Yes. They're actually pretty cool.
Deborah Wiener, WBAL-TV 11 News.